Hello, welcome back to Auto Pop Culture. Today we are going over the New York-based singer called Ravina and her second album called Ashes Awakening. So I got into her first album a little late because the first song I got into her that I realized that this was a person was her song Rush, which is part of this album. And I really, really liked it. I was like, I love the Bollywood influence inside of it. I must know who this person is. Came to, ended up going from there to the music video to a couple other music videos that I also liked. And then I found her Tiny Desk. And I just obsessed, obsessed. It was a great Tiny Desk. I loved it. It was, I think she did Bloom, Still Dreaming, and I think Petals was in it. But I really, really liked that one. So it got me into getting to the album that came out in 2019 called Lucid. And this is a, that album was rough to get through, but also not at the same time. Like it's a weird space where it was, there goes much better light. She's talking about a lot of her traumas that she went through during youth and kind of rediscovering herself in the process of it. So, I really, really liked that. I thought that was really beautiful. It was some tough topics, but it was so beautifully done. And I feel like it was that kind of, it kind of gave me, when I didn't know at all, kind of going into it blind, I thought in my head, I was like, okay, I'm just gonna go into it. And I thought like, ooh, I love these sounds. I love these productions. And then she starts singing and she's, and you start listening to the words like, oh. And it's beautiful, but it's rough. But it's that kind of weird Third Eye Blind kind of what's it called? Semi Charmed Life, where it's like upbeat and you're having fun and you're really talking about meth. And it's just ridiculous. But this one's a much beautiful direction of it. It's beautiful songs, beautiful production, and then just talking about that trauma through it, and it sounds so nice. But we're out of the trauma now with some pieces in it. With this album, we kind of talk about more of like newfound love and getting to know your partner more and finding your own worth in the middle of breaking up. And also just kind of just, it seems like a mix between just finding, I know there's a song that kind of pulled me into it. It's like she's revisiting some of her traumas, but she also is way more sexually empowered. And I love that. I think that's so cool, especially coming off of Lucid. Because in my mind, I always get this nervous thought is like, if you're sexually abused by somebody, especially in youth, it really affects how you see sex inside, as an adult. And so it's surprising and very great when I see people that's been through that and still can revisit and rediscover their sexuality pretty much, and still find and reinvent a more healthier perspective towards it. And I feel like that's exactly what this is, especially when you go into the first song called Rush, that pretty much is very like into that direction of she wants this person to get closer to her. And it's definitely has a much po sex positivity in it. So The Secret featuring Vince Staples, which I'm surprised that Vince Staples was in this. He kills it though. And it works perfectly with the song. I'm pretty much going through the album right now. So let's keep going. So Magic, I thought it was okay. The idea is that when they touch, it feels like magic. And then we go into Kismet, which was a really good song. This one talks about the idea of this woman that she meets is, and she feels like this is meant to be, that their love is meant to be, hence the title of the out or song. I love that song. I love the fact that she's putting a lot of Hindi song or words into this, like hopefully I don't damage this one. Zindagi Ki Kismet, Kismet. And that one pretty much means fate of life, pretty much meant to be kind of thing. And that's what she sees in this woman. Going into the next one, which is Kathy Left for Kamandu. Feels like it changed. I feel like the production changes from Kathy to Mysterious, and Mystery, or Mystery, yes, Catherine Mystery and Circuit Board, I feel like those have his own little like universes, because it feels like the Bollywood inspiration takes a back seat and you put more of a kind of like guitar forward pop in a kind of way, like kind of makes you feel like you're like in the summer space. I don't know why, but it's what I think. And so Kathy left, or left for Kamandu, pretty much talks about the idea of, pretty much, it feels like to me like she's nodding, looking towards the people that come to places like Kathmandu and Bali and all these places to kind of revamp themselves and find rejuvenation and all these things. And they're usually rich, because you got to really have money for this stuff. Rich hippies, as she would call. And she pretty much is like, this Kathy wants to go with her to this thing and reinvent herself and all these things. And she's kind of nodding towards, she's like, yeah, I can do all of that if you got the money. As she says, I can open up your third mind as long as you pay for the price. And it's kind of sad. It's kind of a weird space that maybe she's nodding at the idea that these kind of self-discovery kind of spaces that these people from America and the UK and these people that come into those countries are looking for is something you can kind of find inside yourself, and it's very privileged to go to those places to do that, you know, because not everybody has that money and that opportunity to do so. So a lot of us have to kind of deal with it in our heads and find other ways to rejuvenate ourselves, to revamp ourselves, kind of thing, find clarity with ourselves. So I feel like it's a nice little fun poke at this kind of like style of or trend that people do. Going into Mystery, I really love Mystery. This one talks about the idea of wanting this love interest to see that she's the one for them. And she says, like, if I'll wait it up if you want 300 lifetimes. And then she goes into, I'll trade woozy acid trips for Sundays. And so she's pretty much nodding. She's like, I will trade all of these kind of fun things that I like to partake just to have a very normal, mundane type of life with you, where we're like great raising babies and living in our house and nothing really crazy happening, but it's that life. I want to have that traditional life with you, kind of thing. But she sees that this person is not really looking to get with her, and she's kind of knowing, no, doesn't understand why. She's like, can't you see that I'm meant for you? But then it ends with her saying, I thought, or I can tell you want to be alone. I forget that. And I think in her head, I think she's realizing that this person is not getting, isn't, doesn't want to be with her, or not being with her isn't meant to be taken personal. It's really about her. It's the person that she's interested in. It's about that person's meaning to be alone. Seems like they're going through things and it's not the time for them to look for love at this time. And she feels like she knows that, and she kind of reminded of that, and she's like, oh yeah, I forget that that's what you're doing, because I just immediately think that we're meant to be together, but then you realize that it's more than that. Going into the next song, Circuit Board, this one talks about the idea of wanting to have her partner or lover open up and just kind of let everything out, because it seems like they kind of keep themselves hidden towards her, and she can tell that something wrong, that she feels that the person is not kind of living enough. And this song also has that mixture where the Bollywood starts to come back into main focus, but not yet. It still has that kind of a guitar-y pop kind of direction coming with it, but it can tell that the transition's starting. And then it goes into the internet is like eating plastic. This is spoken word. And it pretty much talks about the internet, the good and the bad about the internet. And she talks about the idea that like the internet is mean, the internet is clean. Were telegraphs so mean? And she thinks, it's a really good question. I wonder what telegraphs were like when it came to sending things. Were there trolls on in the telegraph? Telegram. Not telegraph. Then she goes in and says, the internet makes me stupid and smart at the same time. Then says, the internet has me planning too much. I don't need this much information on pricing for a wedding in Bali for a lover who doesn't exist. And then finally she ends it with, which is, that's about the whole advertisement that internet throws at us constantly. And then it goes into, she ends it with, Gabby has the most beautiful smile. She is becoming one of my best friends. I wonder what happens if I looked up more. And I feel like what she meant in that direction is she's starting to have this friendship bloom with this girl named Abby. And she's finally, and she really feels like this is really going to be a really good, like, relationship. But there's a piece of her that wants to go, what happens if I keep digging? If I keep digging in her background and keep typing in and kind of Facebook stalking her kind of thing and dig back into her past, see more about her, what would I find? Would I find that she's a complete racist, like some other people like to find? Or would I find out that she's not what I thought she's going to be? Would I find that she has more beautiful magic that she has? I don't know. But that whole idea of thinking that you need to look more just to be sure about a person, and not just get to know them as they are, is exactly what the internet has made us get into. We don't trust anybody, and if we do, we're just nosy to know their life that we can't, that we don't have access to from them, you know? It's not asking them for that permission, it's finding it, it's ourselves and knowing it ourselves. Going into the next song, Arrival to the Garden of Cosmic, Spectaculation. I can't speak right now. It's an intermission. And this is, usually I don't start intermissions. I really kind of just leave them alone and just like, okay, cool. That's going into the next thing. I talk about it, but I never start them. But this intermission was so beautiful, and it completely feels like you're going into a next level of something. And you are. Cause when you go into Asha's Kiss featuring, Asha, Pooley, this is such a peaceful production. I never came across such peaceful, but still commercially accurate kind of like song. I just really love it. I love the idea that Asha comes in and she sounds so great. And this is a full 6 minute and 18 second song. It's a long song, but but the atmosphere is what you're there for, and it's so, so nice. It's so nice. Time Flies actually is a song I've been waiting to find where the hell it came from, because it was the song that she kind of teased a bit at the end of her Rush music video, and I thought it was so fucking beautiful. I was like, I need to find that song. I couldn't find it anywhere, and I was like, okay, maybe it'll just come to me and some possibility. And of course, it definitely came to me in this album with a price, because I thought it was about a beautiful song, just talking about just how time flies. But it's deeper than that. It talks about her, it's revisiting her 20s where she was kind of touching on, what's the album again? Lucid. Kind of gives you a lucid touch again by reminding her kind of things that just like she's gone through in her 20s. She says, letting go of my 20s. Thank God I got money. And it feels like it's a mix between talking about her, where she is now or where she's been, mixed with a relationship she's leaving behind as well. In the middle of that, she mentions about a baby that she lost. She says this, and this is very heartbreaking, but it says, lost my baby at 21. I was just a baby. I can't believe I was a mother, even if it was a moment. That definitely hit me in the face, especially coming in the second verse. I was like, whew, wow, we're really digging into that space. And then she kind of questions herself, tell me why I'm compulsively loving you. What if I die before I find someone in time? So it seems like she's questioning herself of her ex that she wants, that she just finds herself just repeatedly just falling and thinking of. And she thinks about, she's like, will I find another person that makes me feel special before I die? And it feels like it's taken a while for her to find that. Love Overgrown talks about pretty much the idea of an overdue breakup and the idea of waiting too long to break it off and having a space where you want to break it off, but you're still in love with this person. And so she says, but she knows that in hindsight, she should have if she felt that way, she should have broke it off way before she's in this conflicted space of should I stay, should I go? I want to stay, want to go kind of thing. And she says, in hindsight, I wish I was earlier in jud to judge. I don't regret those years, but baby, I'm done. And then she goes, why wait till it's overgrown? Why wait till it's more fucked up than, or fallen, then break it off? Wait until we're broken. Wait until we're so in love. So I feel like in that wait until we're broken, pretty much wait until everything just falls fully apart and we completely despise each other, or we're holding on with the idea that maybe if we stay around each other long enough, all this feeling will just vanish and we'll just fall further in love. Which is, I don't really think that's how it works. And I think that's what she knows that, but I think she's making a point in that space. Like, this is what this person wants to see it that way, and I don't think she does. Going into endless summer is also kind of continuing that ending of things. And she talks about, like, why does love end? Why does the summer change? Or why do seasons change? I wish we can just stay in just this endless summer forever, this ha endless happiness, just stay in love forever, stay in these in summer forever, staying in these good times. But we know eventually bad times are just around the corner. Like, it's always there's you're never gonna be in this good space all the time. You know, there's always hardships coming through. Going into New Drugs featuring Tweaks, I thought it was okay. I still trying to figure out exactly what it means, other than the idea that maybe she is kind of telling her, just still figuring herself out as a woman, as a person on this earth, as a lover. And she still feels like she's still working that out, but she knows in her head, she's like, maybe I'll figure out in the next life. Maybe this is not the time. Maybe this life is for me to learn, get all these lessons in, and then the next life is to enjoy the lessons I learned and from learning from it and moving on into that happy space. That's why I'm guessing that's what it means. And then finally, one of the best songs, quote quote, is Let Your Breath Become a Flower. It's a guided meditation. It's a 15 minute long meditation, and I completely did the full 15 minutes. I didn't even look at the lyrics or anything. I followed through what she wanted me to do, close my eyes and meditate, and I did. And it was so beautiful. And I love the fact that Aaron Lau comes in and does it and says born again kind of thing near the end. He's the producer that's been producing with her since her first album, so, or since she's begun. But I love that ending. It's such a great little, like, nice little cleansing of an ending of an album. I think it's so beautiful. I give this album, as much as there was like two songs that thought was okay, the whole premise of this album is so well done. I have to give it a, you know what? Yeah, I'll give it a 10 out of 10. I just really like it. Leave a comment below. Tell me what you thought. If you heard of her before, let me know. What's your favorite song of hers? Did you know Lucid before? Obviously you probably did. But if you did, let me know what your favorite song off of that one too, if you have any history with her, seen her live. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, hit the like button, subscribe button, notification bell too. And thank you for watching.